Today I shall share easy step-by-step tutorial for making a handmade needlebook. Perfect sewing project for beginners and perfect thoughtful handmade gift for anyone who stitches. Today morning was foggy, can't even see my neighbor's house. Day for quiet crafting. This is my sewing box and look how shabby I have been keeping my needles. I want to make a needle book. I want to make a tiny needle book which in fit my palm and sewing box. So I took a sturdy fabric 3-inch wide and 5-inch long. Next, I took a cardstock paper slightly smaller than the first fabric. One can even use fusible fabric. Next, I took flannel or felt fabric, again slightly smaller. I shall start doing blanket stitch on first and outer fabric. So I begin by going in from the back side of the fabric and come out in front and go back in the same spot and come out on the left side of the loop formed. This is the first stitch. Next, I go in again 1/8 of inch right of my first stitch and loop the thread behind the needle and pull it out. This blanket stitch will not only stop any possible fraying of thread but will also give a decorative border. When I reached the corner, I did the stitch before corner, corner and after corner stitch from the same hole. I will try to be as neat as possible and the corner is made. I continue till I finish the whole border and tie a knot on the back side. Then I folded my needle book cover, then folded the front portion again. Using a chalk, I sketched a half portion of a heart and cut it out. So I get a heart shape on my cover page, which I again stitched with blanket stitch. Next, I cut the cardstock paper into two and glued them on each side of the back portion of the cover. This will neaten up the cover, hide all the knots and the loose thread ends, and also make it sturdy. I used PVA glue as it works on most of the surfaces. I left a little gap between the two sides of the cardstock paper. This will give the ease for folding it well and holding all the ingredients and the sheets or pages of my needle book inside. While this dried, I worked on the felt fabric. I have a pretty fabric lace which I cut to the size of the total length. I fixed the lace to the felt using pins and went on doing run stitch one way and back again, stitching the lace to the fabric or sheet of the needle book. Next, I have this pretty lace given by a late aunt of mine. It has pretty velvet flowers and beads. So I cut out a small piece and stitched it on the front page of the needle book with the same color thread. For the back side of this sheet, I took a small colored felt and cut it like a banner or bunting and stitched it on the top. I made sure to hide the knots behind the felt piece. Now I have to put the needle book together. So I placed my cover with the front on the left hand side and the inside facing me, that is the card stock paper facing me. I positioned the sheet on it and held it firmly and stitched the midline together with run stitch. I hit the knot in between. Let's fill it up. Here is my needle book right in my palm. In the first page, the needles look like stems of floral bed in the garden. Next page has all my needles sitting very tidy and organized. The last page holds few pins that I use very often while stitching. This needle book is thin, small, and fits in my sewing kit. Perfect project for beginners and perfect for anyone who loves to stitch. One can make or modify as one pleases. Do let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. Give this video a thumbs up and share it and subscribe to my channel for DIY and crafts within budget if you're new here. I shall see you soon in my next video. Until then, stay positive, be creative and be happy.